Oh my god, okay, you know what? It's really not uncommon at all for a college to screw people over. And I don't just mean for costs. I mean for the kind of things they pull. Holy shit, I'm not even in the college yet, but you will not believe what had already happened to me. I hope that my advisor and or admissions person or the leader of my program doesn't see this video, but I'm not going to name her name either, but I'm just going to tell you what she fucking did, okay? Like, this, I've never been, this is like, oh, okay, here's the, something in my fucking eye, there. 2 years ago, I was in the same college for an upgrading course because I did really poorly in high school because I never studied. Anyway. So, and then I went to this upgrading course 2 years ago, and I left the upgrading course because they lost my marks, and I felt, well, fuck you guys, you're kind of screwing me over, right? So, with that, what happened was I just left the college, and that was it. I got a letter months later after leaving on my own terms that I completed the course. The upgrading course was complete, and I figured, okay, so I now that I have this paper, whenever I do want to go back to college in the future for my actual program, I can just simply show this paper, I'm accepted, da-da-da, I can go whenever I feel like it. Turns out this year, the paper didn't matter because I had only completed one of the programs I was in, but not English. And English was what I needed to get into pretty much any course in existence. So the course that I completed was not English; it was something else. So with that being said, for English, when I was there before I left, I had completed a lot of it, but not enough. So, my options were to either go back to upgrading and finish what I didn't complete, or do what is referred to as a mature student test. I got all this information from this bitch advisor, and I paid $30 for this test because the test was a lot quicker than going back and being off course, obviously. And, so, many times I had to keep going into the college because this bitch never called me back or returned any of my calls or called me or anything because she's so fucking lazy. So, I went into the college to get all this information, you know, the test, and make the payments, etc., etc. And then, I wanted my results. I was supposed to get my results by either simply a letter in the mail and or saying you're accepted on the website. Neither one of those happened, nor did I get a phone call. So I called her, didn't answer the phone. I called her for about a week straight, no, maybe about a week and a half, actually. Didn't answer the phone one single time and didn't return any of my voicemails. So finally, I just simply went into the school. When I went into the school, I didn't talk to her. I talked to someone else who had told me that in the test, there were three parts of the test. I passed two of the tests and failed one part of the test by one mark. They told me that with that, even though I passed two out of three and failed only one of them barely, they would almost let me into the course because A, I failed one part with one mark, and B, the two parts that I did pass are parts that most people don't pass, strangely enough. So they said most likely they'll let me in. So I told this lady to please give the bitch my number to call me back and to actually call me back this time. I waited about 4 days and never did she call me back. Finally, on the 50, I called her out of sheer shits and giggles and luck, and she actually answered the phone. So, then I started talking to her, and I said, what are my marks? Am I accepted? And she go, and I said, you know, I asked her, did I pass this test? And she goes, yes, you passed the test. And I said, you mean almost passed, because one section I failed by one mark. And she goes, no, you passed all the sections. And I said, but I was told I didn't pass everything. I passed two sections and failed one barely. She goes, no, you passed them all. And I thought she was lying, but either way, it was a positive thing, so I let it go. So that was the first lie, aside from not answering. So that was the first thing she did, but aside from not answering the phone to me for so long. And then she also said to me, she goes, yeah, your marks are high enough to get into the school, and you would never actually needed to do upgrading or a mature student test. I said, wait a minute. You're telling me that 2 years ago I went into upgrading and I didn't even need to do it? You're telling me I did a mature student test and paid $30 and I didn't even need to do this fucking test? And she goes, pretty much, because my marks were high enough. And what the thing was that they told me that I only needed to go into do the mature student test and go back into upgrading if I didn't graduate from high school. Because according to their system, I didn't graduate high school. I didn't graduate high school. What is this? Look, do you see what this is? It's a high school diploma. Look at this, you stupid fucks. It's a high school fucking diploma. That is the diploma. This is a picture of all my graduates, okay? This is a picture of all my fucking graduates. And as far as I know, I'm on here somewhere. You'll see my stupid ass fucking face from back in high school. Oh, I can't find myself because it says right here, not featured, M. Constantino. I guess they couldn't fit my picture in here. Thanks. Anyway, that's not the point. The point is, this is a high school diploma! You fucking idiots. So, it gets even better though. What happened after that was, she said, and I said, oh, I did graduate high school, what are you talking about? And she goes, okay, well, can you please scan me or bring into the school a copy of your diploma, aka this? So I said, okay, I'll come into the school. I went home and I figured, nah, wait, I'm not gonna go into the school, I'll just fax it to her. So I faxed it instead. I did call her back and say, okay, I'm gonna fax it to you instead, but she didn't answer the phone, what a surprise. So I simply faxed it, and I sent it to her email, da 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 da. Thing is, however, unlike most people, she didn't email me back and say, you know, thank you. So I figured that I must have accidentally sent it to the wrong email. So the next day I went back into the school again to talk to her, ask her some questions, and also, and of course say, did you get my email? I go into the school, and this is where the best part happens. I go into the school to talk to her directly, and I say, first I say to her was hello, did you get my email when I scanned and faxed you the copy of my diploma? She goes, yeah, I got it. And I looked at her with one of those faces like, and you didn't email me back saying you received it. Why? I didn't say anything because at that point I was still trying to keep my cool. So we go into down and I say to her, so did I pass the test? And she goes, well, yeah, of course you passed. And I said, well, am I into the course? She goes, yeah, you accepted. I told you just last week. And I thought, actually, you didn't tell me last week, but okay. I let that go. Oh, sorry, I almost forgot. When I talked to her the first time on the phone, she had told me right there that I had already... Remember how I said that she told me that I passed all three? Remember that? Yeah. Right when she told me that, I said to her, oh, I passed all three? And she goes, yeah, I told you that last week. She actually didn't tell me that either. Anyway, back to the next part. When I said my acceptance, she goes, yeah, because I told you that last week as well. And in my head, again, I'm thinking, no, you actually didn't tell me that. But again, I let it go. And then it gets even better. I said, okay, so is the system all fixed up? You know, according to the system, am I now graduated high school? And she said, what are you talking about? I never told you you weren't graduated. You never told me I wasn't graduated. Okay, not only are you lying yet again, but even if I was graduated the whole time, why the fuck would you ask me for a copy of my fucking diploma, you stupid cunt? So that was yet was a fourth lie now. Then, oh my god. Then, because of all my catching her in lies and asking so many questions, and am I accepted? Did I pass the test? Am I da 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 da? She had the nerve to say to me, why are you so anxious? I'm anxious? I'm anxious because I want to be accepted into my course and not give the school $10,000 just to find out that I'm not accepted, and because I want to punch you in your fucking face. That's why I'm anxious. It was just ridiculous. She lied to me about my test scores. She didn't call me back. She lied to me about whether if I passed or not. She lied to me whether if I'm accepted or not. She lied to me about the high school problem. Oh, and here's the clincher. When I talked to her on the phone the week before, and she said to me that I didn't need to take the mature student test and the upgrading if I didn't pass high school, when she found out that I did pass high school with the proof, I said to her, so I said, now that you have my proof, is it true that I didn't actually need to do the mature student test or the upgrading? She goes, yeah, you did. I said, but I passed high school. Isn't that all you needed? She goes, no, you needed to pass high school, but you also needed to do the mature student test and upgrading. And again, right there, I'm thinking to myself, but on the phone, you told me I didn't need to do those two after all. So that was the fifth lie. If any of you are trying to get into college or university, this is what they do before you even get into the course, okay? Fuck. Okay, I finally got that out. What a fucking nightmare. Have a good night, guys.